Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 111th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 911.
One ignition and lift off of Falcon 9. Go Starlink, go SpaceX.
The boost which launched this mission, B1082, then landed successfully for the second time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Later in the day on Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 112th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 668.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1076, then landed successfully for the 18th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Later today and going into the week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of Falcon missions. The first of these, the Optus X mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 17th at 9:29pm UTC or 4:29pm EST. Then tomorrow, we can hopefully expect to see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 912 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 18th at 5:47am UTC or 12:47am EST. Later the same day and we should see a customer mission launch. The GSAT-20 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 18th at 6:31pm UTC or 1:31pm EST. A few days after that and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 666 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 21st at 3:53pm UTC or 10:53am EST. Finally, the following day we can hopefully expect to see yet another Starlink launch. The Starlink 913 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 22nd at 4:13am UTC or Thursday 21st at 11:13pm EST. SpaceX has gained some more Falcon 9 launches with a contract with Impulse Space. This article says Impulse Space has purchased 3 Falcon 9 launches for its Helios transfer vehicle for missions starting in 2026, including one for the Space Force. SpaceX posted some information about the second Starlink launch we saw earlier. They said Falcon 9 lifts off from Pad 40 in Florida, completing our 17th launch in 31 days. There was an interesting post about how much SpaceX has saved the US government. It says, a senior guy in the Space Force told me that their estimates are that SpaceX have saved them $40 billion since they started contracting with them, which goes all the way back to when they were still part of the Air Force. This is due to better performance and lower cost than the legacy cost-plus contracts for the military industrial establishment. Heading to Boca Chica, SpaceX recently did a water deluge test as they prepare for Starship Flight 6. The draw works for lifting the chopstick catching arms on the orbital Pad B tower was moved to the launch site and installed. Here's a look at a bunch of nose cones spotted inside Star Factory. The SpaceX logo on the side of Star Factory was seen lit up. A bunch of Raptor engines were recently seen moved into Mega Bay 2. As we saw last video, Starship 31 was rolled to the launch site. SpaceX posted some pictures of Booster 13 rolling back out to the launch site as they prepare for Flight 6. They said Super Heavy Booster moved to the launch mount at Starbase in preparation for stack and flight. SpaceX posted some information with an updated launch date for the Starship Flight 6 mission. They said targeting Tuesday, November 19th for Starship 6 flight test. A 30-minute launch window opens at 4pm Central Time. There was some information from Gwynne Shotwell on the number of Starship launches she thinks they will do over the next 4 years. It says, I would not be surprised if we fly 400 Starship launches in the next 4 years. Musk responded with, hopefully way more. Here's a shot of Booster 13 being moved to the launch site. It was also lifted onto the orbital launch mount. Starship 31 was then stacked atop Booster 13 for the launch of Starship Flight 6. The flight termination explosives were also installed on Booster 13. Another super heavy booster 16 barrel section was seen moving recently. Taking a look at the Cameron County website again, SpaceX have their closures for Flight 6 still. They have a closure scheduled for today, Sunday 17th, and tomorrow, Monday 18th, but I'd assume this is just for testing. However, they also have possible closures for Starship Flight 6 on Tuesday 19th and Wednesday 20th. As always, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.